food on the table. With a bit of planning, we can make great family meals go further to save money. Nutritionist and chef Georgia Lienemann is here to show us how. Let's welcome her, Studio 10. Now, Georgia, you believe in nose-to-tail nutrition. Is it just about being smart with what we make?
It's about being very smart. Nose-to-tail nutrition is all about using every part of the animal, and there's a few benefits to doing that. Not only is it a lot cheaper, generally it requires less cooking, because you buy one. We've got the whole chicken here used into four meals today.
Is it a lot of bits, though?
Yeah. But we basically, like, there's less packaging, it's better for the environment, and it's much more balanced nutrition, because there's nutrients in every single part of the animal. We tend to just focus on one part.
Now, you've brought in four dishes.
Yes.
From one bird.
From one bird.
So what do you want to start with?
Well, I'll tell you how I made it. Basically, instead of buying chicken breasts and chicken legs and all the different parts of it, what we would do is put the whole chicken in a big pot with some stock ingredients, some carrots and onions and some herbs. And then I basically simmer that for 2 hours and pull all the meat off to make my Sancho Bao.
Don't you get a heap of meat?
Heaps.
You do.
And also the whole chicken.
Yeah, so it's very easy. That step, you just throw it in. You don't have to think about it. And then you've got the beautiful broth. And with the broth, we make a tom yum and what I call a savoury porridge, which is my favourite breakfast recipe, which is basically...
Wouldn't be mine.
It's very unusual, but it's high protein. It's more satisfying than normal oats because there's protein there, and it's very, very nourishing. But the meat I use to make Sancho Bao and the coleslaw. It's all Asian flavours, because I'm trying to eat a diverse range of really spicy, flavourful foods while I'm pregnant.
Get the baby ready.
Very good idea.
Now, you've cooked... with Indira?
No, Indira and I do.
Yeah, she's got a vertical garden.
And she does, and Costa Georgia. I interviewed them. I have a program called What to Eat. It's an online program. And we interviewed Indira about how to get started growing your own food. Because obviously that's the most nutrient-dense way to eat. It's really fresh.
Because that's the thing, even if you've got a patio and you live in a flat or something, you can have all the herbs, your vegetables and everything on a vertical garden. Really look into it, because there's nothing better than fresh.
It's really true. We tend to look for antioxidants and supplements, but there's more antioxidants in your herbs fresh out of the garden than anywhere else. It's really potent.
I think we should have a taste test, and you can just take us through how you made each one.
Yep.
All right, let's start with the Sancho Bao.
Okay, so I don't know how you're going to do that. That's a bit messy for television, isn't it?
There's no neat way to do this. I'm just going to...
Go for it. She's not a fan of coriander.
No. No.
Beautiful.
Tissue? So,
do you want to try the tom yum?
Hang on a second. What's this got in it?
So basically it's the chicken meat. The chicken meat becomes very, very tender. I've got some carrot, but you can throw any vegetables in there, any herbs.
Do you
herbs.
Use any water chestnuts?
I've got macadamia nuts in there, because I like to use local Australian foods. Some bean sprouts, some carrots, shallots, and then a little bit of fish sauce. And you can throw anything in there, any like leftovers out of the fridge even.
And now next we've got the savoury porridge.
I know it doesn't. I know. My whole family gusts.
I really like a savoury porridge, but I never had it for breakfast.
It's traditional. Everywhere else in the world they have congee, they have all sorts of savoury versions of porridge, and it's actually really delicious. Garlic, you can melt a little bit of butter over there, and I use the chicken broth to cook it in. So it's more like a savoury dish.
Sounds like something you could have as a meal, not brekkie.
It's good for any time of the day. If you're obviously going to be kissing people or close to people, you leave out the garlic.
Never worry, me now. And what's in this?
So tom yum. That's one of my most popular recipes. It's delicious, obviously Asian inspired again. Cooked with broth, a little bit of the leftover chicken meat. I love putting prawns in there as well, but it's literally 10 minutes to make this meal.
Okay, so what veggies have you got in there though?
I've got tomatoes, mushrooms, and basically a whole bunch of coriander. So don't be touching that one.
No. And then we go to the coleslaw.
You're not planning a trip to Asia anytime soon.
More coriander in this
no,
one.
No, I always ask, no coriander. Because I love Asian food.
Yeah,
I love
it's apparently it's a genetic thing, the coriander thing. You either have the gene or you don't. Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah, it's true.
I've got a gene. I was lacking.
Never think that.
So this is really straightforward. Just chop everything up. Just a little bit of.
Now hang on. You say everything that to somebody that doesn't do.
No, this is
to Jess. Yeah. She needs to know exactly.
Okay, so it's wombok. It's Chinese cabbage. And then we've just got a whole range of Asian... We have a really big garden at our place. So we've got Vietnamese mint, coriander, what else have I got? Kaffir lime leaf, and then just carrots, and you can put water chestnuts in. I've got macadamia nuts, and then a really beautiful dressing as well.
So for people who don't have a lot of time, that's probably most of us,
yep.
How easy are these recipes to prepare?
These ones are simple. I would say that's the most time-consuming, the salad, because there's so many different ingredients, but again, it's just chopping it up. These ones are really straightforward. Savoury porridge is 5 minutes, the tom yum is 10. So it's just a case of being able to utilise, you know, the one chicken can provide 4 meals over 2 days.
And a lot of your Asian greens are so cheap. You can get bok choy for $1 a bunch.
Yeah,
it's fantastic.
And very, very nutrient dense as well.
Well, Georgia's book is called 4 Meals from 1 Bird, Your Guide to Making Food Go Further. It is free to download at her website, stirringchange.com. Let's please thank Georgia now.
Thank you.
And little Lienemann.